European Union is the leading development partner for civil society in the Eastern Partnership countries and is ready to support the civil society organizations in further developing their skills and capacity. One of the main challenges of the civil society organizations in Moldova and in the region is their sustainability, both in terms of financing and capacity. Very often, once a project has come to an end, and donor funding ceases, the organization no longer has the financial means to continue its mandate and faces the risk of inactivity. It is important that civil society organizations build up their capacities and develop mechanisms to find sources from places other than external donor funding. This is why it is good to see the issue of financial sustainability addressed in today's agenda. In Moldova, the European Union follows very closely the developments related to financial sustainability of the civil society organizations, like the so-called 2% law allowing citizens to divert part of their taxes towards the non-profit sector. We also follow very closely the developments related to the legal environment, mainly the new NGO law, recently passed in the first reading in the Moldovan Parliament. We expect for the new law to be adopted very soon without major changes and for the best benefit of the Moldovan civil society organizations. Since 2014, the EU delegation to Moldova, together with the EU member states' embassies, has adopted a country roadmap for engaging with civil society. This document presents a comprehensive, coherent, and shared analysis of EU's and member states of civil society's landscape, its enabling environment, and the challenges and opportunities faced by civil society organizations. It also identifies common EU priorities and concrete steps for engaging with and supporting non-governmental organizations in Moldova. In light of the revised neighborhood policy and the EU commitment to enhance and diversify our engagement with civil society, we are planning a review of this roadmap for a period of 2018-20. We are planning to consult with the representatives of the local civil society our next priorities for engagement in the next couple of months. Therefore, I would like to invite you to start a reflection on how we can improve the systematic and strategic involvement and consultation of civil society in all sectors of support interventions and policy dialogue. Allow me again to thank you for what you are doing within your fields of activities. Allow me to thank Chairman of the Commission of the Parliament, Ms. Buliga, to Ms. Miller for being here today, to organizers to organizing this fantastic gathering. And please make the best use of this opportunity to share also best practices, your experiences, how to promote all good ideas, also what to do if we are facing challenges, because we do see from time to time challenges, ideas that have as aim limiting the activities of the civil society. That is also equally important to keep the achieved level of democratic development, to protect them and to promote them further.